Hey guys, this is Mickey from coinopnewyork.com, coinopny.com, and Mickey's Antique Amusements. And we're live in my gamer room. There's my bowling machine and my diner booths and my wall boxes. Anyways, let's get to why we're here. Anyways, this is a 1950-51 3W1 Seberg 100 Select wall box. And what we did was is we hooked it up to the Wallbox to iPod adapter system. And you buy this from Data Sync Engineering. It costs $100. And they give you instructions on how to hook it up. And that's what we did. So we went ahead and took this unit apart, this 3W1. And this one was needed a lot of work. And we probably got easily 15, 20 hours into it. Usually, to do one of these setups, usually about 5 to 10 hours. This one had a lot of issues that we had to sort out: wiring issues, broken wires, power supply, stopper unit, all sorts of crazy things on this one. But anyways, we've got it up and running. Let's go ahead and show you what we got here. We have the adapter. This is it right here, as you can see. And there's a lot of wires that run in and out of it. There is a wire for the power. There's a wire to run it to the iPod. There is a wire to have the knockoff switch here. Right here, you see this little knockoff switch. And then there's also a wire for the audio, which is right here. These can run into any AV receiver that you like, these RCA plugs. You get stereo. There you go. So everything runs out of this little adapter here that they sell you, okay? And then you have to wire up a power supply. And we're going to show you how to do that later. We're not going to show you everything, but we're going to show you the Reader's Digest version and on how to do it. But anyways, this is I don't know what version this iPod is. It's definitely an older iPod. You know, it's nothing special. You can buy these off Craigslist or eBay for or 20 or 30 bucks. It's a two gig one. And then what I did was normally when you do these, you hook this up right here, this iPod wall box adapter, you hook the RCA plugs up to a AV receiver. But what we did was is we bought one of these little Bluetooth sending units off of eBay. They go for around 20 bucks, and we hooked it into the earphone plug on the iPod. So what you end up with is a way to wirelessly send the music to a Bluetooth speaker. And I have this little portable Bluetooth speaker here. Obviously, you can buy larger Bluetooth speakers. You can buy really, really, really nice ones that'll fill the whole room with music. And the good part about it is it's wireless, so you won't be able to see it. So all these wires over here will be hidden when you set up your wall box, when you do get one of these in your diner or wherever you're going to put it. You're not going to see anything really except some wires coming off the back, but those will be hidden either underneath it or back behind the back side of the table and all that. So anyways, you know, you just go ahead and you follow the directions. It's not too hard to do. And then once you get it up and running, we're going to show you how this works. And it works great. 3 plays for a quarter. We have it set on 3 plays for a quarter. And we have all the lights working in here. This lights in here light up. The select light lights up down in there. If we were to turn the lights off, you'd see the lights down around these buttons in here. So that's what we got. So we're going to play 3 Beatles songs. This is for informational purposes only on how to this jukebox wall box system works. No copyright infringement intended. YouTube, this is for demonstration purposes only. So we're going to stick a quarter in here and we're going to play 3 Beatles songs. And I have a list. I didn't make up title strips yet, but we're going to play 3 Beatles songs. We won't play them all the way through, but let's go ahead and give it a whirl here. So let's go ahead and stick a quarter in here. And then you can see the select light lights up and we're ready to go. And let's see what we can play here. Let's Let's see. How about Can't Buy Me Love? I saw her standing there and my guitar gently weeps. We're going to play those three songs. So let's go ahead and punch them in. E. Four.
Can't buy me love.
Okay, last song. All right, we're going to go ahead and knock that off. So that was the three Beatles songs. And as you can see over in my diner booth area over here, I have two Seberg wall boxes, and you can see you don't see any wires anywhere. There's some wires hanging down over here, but they're underneath the table, so they're sort of tucked away. So that's sort of what you do with that. So anyways, you can use a lot of different wall boxes. You see that? There's quite a bit of wall boxes on here that you can use. Wolitzers, Rose, Rockolas, Seabergs, AMIs. You know, you can use a lot of different wall boxes. Anyway, so there you go. That's a demonstration of a Seberg 3W1 wall box converted with iPod using a Bluetooth transmitter to transmit to a wireless Bluetooth speaker. You can obviously hook this up to a an AV receiver by plugging in the cords off your iPod adapter that you buy from DataSync Engineering. Okay, so there you go. There's a nice little demonstration.